Hey viewers, you probably haven't heard about selenium, and we don't blame you. It's been a fairly overlooked mineral in terms of its importance in your body. And it's only in the past 20 years that our understanding of the significance of selenium in the nutrition of humans has grown. It's a trace mineral that plays a fundamental part in our health. Mostly, it's found in your kidneys, liver, pancreas, spleen, and lymph nodes. So a large range of bodily functions can be affected by the amount of selenium you ingest. Understandably, a deficiency of this mineral can be bad for you. So it's important for you to recognize the signs of selenium deficiency, and in today's video, we'll be telling you what those signs are. From muscle weakness, fatigue, hair loss, infertility, to a weakened immune system, we're talking about all that and more. So keep watching until the end to find out all of them. Before we start, let us tell you what exactly selenium is. Selenium is a trace mineral, and you need it in much smaller quantities than many other minerals. It's involved in many processes throughout your body, but you can't make trace elements yourself. This means that you need to get enough selenium through your diets or supplements every day. Many of its health benefits are brought about by proteins containing selenium, called selenoprotein. So, how much selenium do you really need? Adults don't need a lot of selenium, but you do need some in order to keep major systems in your body functioning the way they should. The recommended daily allowance for adults over the age of 14 is 55 micrograms daily, though this number jumps to 60 micrograms for pregnant women and 70 micrograms for breastfeeding women. How can you diagnose selenium deficiency? Diagnosing selenium deficiency can be challenging. That's not only because some symptoms are nonspecific, but also due to the fact that there isn't a test for serum selenium that's universally available. What your healthcare professional may do is test your levels of glutathione peroxidase, which requires selenium to function. Okay, now you know what selenium actually is, let's talk about the signs of its deficiency. Number 1. Foggy mental state. Mental fog can happen if your selenium intake dips low enough to cause deficiency. This symptom is also nonspecific, but it may help your healthcare provider diagnose you if it's considered in combination with other symptoms. One study did find that low selenium levels were associated with poor function on cognitive tests by older adults, although researchers say more research is needed. This video working well for you so far? Well, keep watching, because there's a lot more good stuff coming up. But before moving on, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos like this and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any updates. Number 2. Muscle weakness. When you think of muscles, you may think of your skeletal muscles specifically and forget about your cardiac muscles. Skeletal muscle disorders that cause weakness, pain, and fatigue have been reported in patients with low selenium levels. But selenium deficiency is also known to affect your heart muscles, as it does in the case of Cushon disease. But muscle weakness can also happen with patients receiving perinatal nutrition when they're fed nutrition through an IV, bypassing the digestive system entirely. This is because liquid nutrition tends to be low in this micronutrient. Number 3. Unwanted weight gain. When you experience unwanted weight gain, you'll want to get to the root cause. Your thyroid's thirst for selenium may play a role, and fixing that inadequacy can help your thyroid get back online. Although you may want to look at your diet when you're gaining weight, and then consider testing selenium levels down the line. Number 4. You may be at a higher risk for certain cancers. You're probably up for doing whatever you can to prevent cancer, and maintaining optimum levels of selenium may reshuffle the deck in your favor. Researchers analyzed observational studies to look at the link between selenium and cancer. What they found was a 31% lower risk of cancer associated with higher selenium exposure, particularly with stomach, bladder, and prostate cancer. But other trials failed to show a benefit from selenium. Without concrete evidence, the authors conclude that supplements probably aren't the answer. Instead, focus on the foods you eat, and that will probably provide a range of health benefits, including selenium-rich foods like asparagus, broccoli, and mushrooms. Number 5. Hair loss or change in hair quality and texture. Are you experiencing slight changes in your hair? Perhaps your hair isn't growing as much as it once was. You're losing more when you wash your hair or comb your hair, or your hair isn't quite as luxurious as it once was, meaning it's losing its shine or luster. All of these symptoms may be related to your micronutrient status, including selenium levels. Although all hair loss may not be caused by selenium deficiency, and if traditional hair regrowth therapies have not worked for you, then it may be time to look into selenium deficiency. Another very important point worth mentioning is that selenium deficiency rarely tends to appear by itself and is often accompanied by other nutrient deficiencies. This is important because other micronutrients such as iron, zinc, biotin, and selenium are all required for proper hair growth. Number 6. Thyroid dysfunction. Probably one of the most profound effects of selenium deficiency is the effect that it has on your thyroid. Selenium deficiency has been shown to directly impair thyroid hormone production from the thyroid gland. It may be entirely possible that the symptoms of selenium deficiency may actually be mediated through their effects on your thyroid. If you're experiencing any of the symptoms of selenium deficiency, it would also be prudent to evaluate your thyroid function in your body with a complete thyroid lab panel. Number 7. Weakened immune system. Does it feel like you're getting every cold or virus or bug that you come in contact with? A weakened immune system from selenium deficiency may be the culprit. Selenium, through its effect as an antioxidant, is required for optimal immune function in your body. Beyond its direct effects on inflammation, selenium is also a critical part of a family of enzymes that help your body produce antioxidants. Supplementing your body with selenium has been shown to improve immune function in certain individuals. It may be through its incorporation into these enzymes that selenium supplementation helps promote immune function. In addition, it's been shown that supplementing with selenium daily for 3 months may help patients with the autoimmune disease Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Number 8. Slow wound healing. Got a cut or a bruise that just doesn't heal as quickly as it should? Maybe you're not getting enough selenium. Part of the benefit of selenium being an antioxidant is that it helps cell tissue repair. When wounds don't heal, or heal very slowly, it's worth examining your selenium status, as research suggests that selenium may help wounds heal faster. Number 9. Chronic cold or flu. Selenium supports your immune system and contributes to your body's natural defenses against cold, flu, and other immune-compromised conditions. Hypothyroidism, a condition that can be influenced by selenium deficiency, negatively interferes with the immune system's response to invading germs. The immune system also requires cells to communicate with each other when dealing with germs and bacteria. Selenium, as an antioxidant, supports this communication. Number 10. Reproductive problems. Deficiencies in selenium can not only cause issues with infertility but also problems during gestation if a woman is able to get pregnant. There's a correlation between selenium levels and fertility, but low levels in the early stages of pregnancy are also associated with miscarriage, low birth weight, and damage to the immune and nervous system of the fetus. Number 11. Fatigue. Another common selenium deficiency symptom is fatigue. This may be due to the fact that poor selenium levels slow down your thyroid. Although you may want to knock out the obvious lifestyle factors before looking into selenium, those may be ensuring that your diet has adequate levels of carbohydrates, protein, and fat, looking for a vitamin D deficiency, or analyzing iron levels. How can you treat selenium deficiency? The first line treatment for selenium deficiency is to try to eat more foods that are high in selenium. Selenium-rich foods include Brazil nuts, yellowfin tuna, rice, beans, and whole wheat bread. When foods high in selenium aren't an option, selenium supplements can also help. Many multivitamins contain selenium, but you can also find it as a standalone product. Selenium supplements usually come in the form of selenomethionine or selenite. Selenomethionine tends to be easier for the body to absorb, so it may be a better option for more severe deficiency cases. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration doesn't monitor the purity or quality of supplements like they do for drugs. Talk to your doctor before beginning to take a selenium supplement. Make sure you don't overdo your selenium intake, as it can lead to selenosis or selenium toxicity. Signs of too much selenium include garlic-like odor from your breath and a metallic-like taste in your mouth. This is dangerous and can cause side effects such as hair loss, fatigue, nausea, and vomiting. Did you know anything about selenium deficiency before this video? Have you ever had this deficiency? Let us know in the comment section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.